preponderance of rare and exotic injuries makes this place perfect for the study of suffering. The courtyard and gardens surrounding the manor were once a point of pride for the diligent custodians I employed. Great banquets and lavish social affairs were hosted here under the stars. Despite the expectation of propriety normally ascribed to those in our position, we mocked the stoic melancholy of the moss-covered fountains and cherubic statues. Our salacious trysts half hidden in the hedgerows, our morality slipping ever deeper into the mud. Soaked and sinking, these stone terraces and sprawling gardens were the site of long forgotten revelry and well remembered regret. Obliterated. Confluence of skill and purpose. Is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Skins. Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken. This expedition at least promises success. Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. As victories mount, so too will resistance. Give them no quarter. Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light? Thank you.
Jason. Unnatural and abhorrent. Set the stage for heroism or cowardice. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. Of multitudinous wings abates. Let us hope that is the end of things.
In those younger years, my home was a hive of unbridled hedonism. A roiling apiary where instinct and impulse were indulged with wild abandon. A bewitching predator slipped in amidst the swarm of tittering sycophants. Though outwardly urbane, I could sense in her a mocking thirst. Driven half-mad by cloying vulgarity, I plotted to rid myself of this lurking threat in a grand display of sadistic sport. But as the moment of murder drew nigh, the gibbous moon revealed her inhuman desires in all their stultifying hideousness.